We've already taken definite integrals, and we've seen how they represent, or they denote the area under a function between two points and above the x-axis. But let's do something interesting. Let's think about a definite integral of f of x dx. So it's the area under the curve f of x. But instead of it being between two different x values, say a and b, like we've seen multiple times, let's say it's between the same one. Let's say it's between c and c, or let's say c is right over here. What do you think this thing right over here is going to be equal to? What does this represent? What is this equal to? And I encourage you to pause the video and try to think about it. Well, if you try to visualize it, you're thinking about, OK, the area under the curve f of x above the x-axis from x equals c to x equals c. So this region, I guess we could call it, that we think about it, does have a height. The height here is f of c. But what's the width? Well, there is no width. We're just at a single point. We're not going from c to c plus some delta x, or c plus some even very small change in x, or some c plus some other very small value. We're just saying at the point c. So we really, when we're thinking about area, we're thinking about how much two-dimensional space you're taking up. But this idea, this is just a one-dimensional, I guess you could think of it as a line segment. What's the area of a line segment? Well, a line segment has no area. So this thing right over here is going to be equal to 0. Now, you might say, OK, I get that. I see why that could make sense, why that makes intuitive sense. I'm trying to find the area of a rectangle where I know its height, but its width is 0. So that area is going to be 0, is one way to think about it. But Sal, why are you even pointing this out to me? And as we'll see, especially when we do more complex definite integration problems and solving things, sometimes recognizing this will help you simplify an integration problem dramatically. Or you could work to being able to get to a point like this so that you can cancel things out, or you can say, hey, oh, that thing right over there is just going to be equal to 0.